this is an example of one of our cart cabinets here. We put Teflon on the side walls and the back walls, so as the guys are putting the carts into the trailer, they're not scuffing up the white aluminum on the side walls. It helps keep the trailer a little lighter, and it does finish off the back walls, so you're not seeing exposed post in the construction of the trailer, if you will. Plenty of airliner tracks so the guys can secure the carts into place. By having a cart cabinet like this, the guys can be at Daytona, for example, and have all the equipment that they need for Daytona. Then they can come back to the shop, offload this cart, put the next cart in for the next race, and it just keeps the inventory on the trailer a lot cleaner for them. As we progress further into the trailer, we get into the front end where the food prep area is. Some team, it's kind of 50-50 on some teams. They would rather have the food closer to the lounge. Some teams would rather have their food at the back end of the trailer so the guys can come in, get what they need, and get out. This particular model, we have the food area up front. Got a refrigerator freezer. Got your coffee maker here for morning coffee. Plenty of overhead storage so the guys can keep what they need where they need it. And then a microwave up front. Under the workbench area here, we have engine storage compartments. Most of the teams will keep one or two motors in here. They're a lift-off door so that you can have easy access to that equipment and roll it in and out. On this side of the trailer, we have an additional workbench again. Plenty of steel roller drawer cabinets. They're about a 400-pound drawer capacity, so they're plenty of oomph there, so you can load them up pretty heavily. Our second air conditioning unit in this trailer, again, it's a 14,000 BTU to cool this front section of the work area. The last area in the work area here is for the shock dyno guy. We try to tuck him away in a corner so as the guys are coming in and out of the center aisle, he's tucked in against the sidewall. His dyno machine would sit here. His computer would sit up on the top of the workbench. He's got his own roller drawer cabinet there so that he can utilize all the small parts that he needs to build and rebuild shocks, and then storage underneath in this cabinet for all of his extra shocks and what have you. As we progress up into the lounge area, we have a little entryway here that there's storage underneath the steps so that we can utilize all the storage that is available in a transporter like this. This area is also access to the upper deck. So we've got step cleats on the side of the trailer, walls here going up into the lounge so the guys can set their feet on that, and we have an access through a roll-up door to get to the front end of the vehicles to get to storage that's up overhead in the lounge area. Okay, we're now up in the upper deck of the trailer. This particular unit, being a truck trailer, is a little bit taller than on a Sprint trailer or on a Nationwide trailer, but this trailer here with the truck upper deck gives me about 67 inches of headroom in this area, which you want to keep that as a minimum so that you can keep maximum height down in the work area for the teams. This area is equipped to handle two vehicles, whether it's a car tomorrow, a Nationwide car, or the truck series. We also show a couple of the tire racks that we build for the teams up here so they can haul tires around either to a test or depending upon the series that they can utilize tires beforehand. All the trailers are equipped with either the D-rings in the floor like we have in this trailer, or we put a track in the floor so that you can basically tie every inch or two. Again, we show the canopy in the roof of the trailer. This utilizes the most ground clearance for the vehicle, and it gives you the most headroom in the lower deck of the trailer. Other than that, there's not a lot of work that happens up here, but the most important part of the trailer is getting the cars there, and this is where we utilize that area at. Okay, we're now up into the lounge area where a lot of the team owners, any more of the team engineers, will do most of their work. It's set up with leather sofas, storage underneath. Again, our third air conditioning unit, the air conditioning in a lounge area, rather than having one 14,000 BTU unit, is split into two so you don't have that huge rush of air on you as you're sitting up in this area. The counter is set up for two engineers in this trailer. There's also an additional work space at the end of the counter, so you can have three people working at the counter. All of the wiring, everything for their networking is all in a recessed chase here, so you have a place to tuck your wires away. The monitor here, they can set that up for either track feed, timing and scoring. They can have the reception from the TV that's mounted on the top of the generator compartment that's located on the front of the trailer. So everything in this is kind of the command center for a race team on a weekend at a race. As we look at the back wall here, we've got a crew locker area. Again, it's more two closets, one normally for a driver and the other one for either the crew chief or the team owner. Your DVD player is in the back, the controls for all of your satellite dish. The car stereo is in here. That's also equipped so that the team radios can go through the car stereo on this unit. And then all of your wiring for your hub, your Pi radio system, timing and scoring. There's a weather station in here. Pretty much everything that you need to operate a race team away from your shop. So other than that, we at Featherlite build about 90 of these units a year. They all start from scratch. We build everything from the ground up, and we specifically build each trailer for each individual team. So thank you for your time. I hope you enjoyed the tour, and we will talk to you soon. Bye.